Xenogamy means transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma from flower, from one plant to reach to the stigma of another flower of another plant belongs to the same species. Okay, transfer of pollen grain from the anther of one flower from one plant reach to stigma of another flower of another plant belongs to same species. So species the same, but plants are the different. Transfer of pollen grain from the transfer of pollen grain from the anther of one flower from one plant reach to stigma of another flower of another plant. Another flower of another plant belongs to same species. That is known as a xenogamy. In this, plants are different, flowers are different. Okay? One plant of flower start and the releasing of the pollen grain reach to the stigma of another flower of another plant belongs to that same species. So that is known as a xenogamy. In this, flowers are different, plants are different, but belongs to same species. It is a 100% cross pollination. So that is known as types of pollination. After that, pollination agents. For the transfer of pollen grain reach to the stigma of another flower, okay, by the factors, by the agents, okay, they are known as pollinating agents. Transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of another flower by the medium. So they are known as the pollinating agents. Generally, in lower class, water is act as medium for the transfer of pollen grain. For that, transfer of male gamete reach to the egg cell. For example, bryophyta and pteridophyta, male gametes are motile. They are swimming the water and reach to that egg cell. Okay, so in this, water is act as a medium. Okay, so in this pollination, okay, for that transfer of pollen grain reach to the stigma of pistil. So some mediums or some agents are helped. They are known as the pollinating agents. So this pollinating agents are two types. First one is that abiotic agents are factors. Abiotic, second one is a biotic. Abiotic means, so generally they are known as wind and water. So they are known as abiotic agent. In almost all plants are okay. So it is an abiotic agents is less. Almost all the plants are, most of the plants, okay, involved in that, okay, cross pollination takes place by that biotic agent. polynomials. Okay, you can see insects, birds, okay, different, okay, are living organisms are involved. Further, okay, cross pollination, they are known as biotic agents. In this, so we discuss about that, okay, abiotic agents. Whether abiotic agent, most common method of abiotic pollination is known as wind pollination. In abiotic agents, most common abiotic is wind. Okay, so transfer of pollen grains from the anthers to the stigma of another flower by the wind. So that pollination is known as the entomophily. Pollination takes place by wind. So that is known as anemophily, by air. Right? So in that anemophily, what are the advantages? Generally, anemophily or wind pollination is occurring in grasslands. Wind pollination is generally occurring in grasslands. Poaceae family. So, what are the characteristics of the wind pollination? For example, pollen grains are lightweight and non-sticky nature. Because of the lightweight and non-sticky nature, so they are easily spread by the wind currents. Okay, next, stamens are long and exposed to the atmosphere, exposed to outside. Okay, next, style and stigma.
Flowers are small to form that inflorescence, it is known as inflorescence.
The leaf flower having that single ovule, silky like stamens and stigma, carnauba, example, that is known as a maize.